so many vehicles, so many people paying such a wonderful tribute to such a great guy. That was the best thing I've ever seen.
Hundreds of residents lined the streets this afternoon to honor fallen Midland County Deputy Sheriff Mike Naylor.
Today, law enforcement officers, as we said, from all across the country made their way to the Permian Basin to say their final goodbyes.
CBS 7's Lauren Landman was on the road today from Midland to New Mexico, where Sergeant Naylor was laid to rest. Lauren?
Jay Tatum, the 98-mile drive to Hobbs, New Mexico was anything but normal today. Today, hundreds of residents packed the streets to show their support for the fallen deputy, a true tribute of honor for a man that meant so much to his community.
There were signs made. One little boy had a green sign that said, "We love you, Uncle Mike." Well, that, you talk about bringing tears. It's an amazing country. Amazing country.
Dozens of law enforcement vehicles and hundreds of residents with flags was the scene all across West Texas this afternoon. It's a pure sign of patriotism and respect shown to the family, whether they knew them or not.
I thought it was a way to explain and show Rye how to respect.
Honoring the sheriff who died.
The sheriff who died, that's right.
98 miles and one state later, Sergeant Naylor's resting place was found in a somber cemetery on the outside of town.
This is a tribute to a man that gave his all for the community he lived in, trying to do his job, trying to serve an arrest warrant on a child predator. And that was his goal in life, was to help people. And he was helping a child by serving this warrant, by keeping a child predator away.
Rows of law enforcement men and women from all parts of the country stood as they wished their brother in blue one final farewell.
You take one step and then the next and then the next and you keep going. God gives us a charge to live our life in his light. We do that by moving forward.
All uniform personnel, present!
Tatum, Jay, just about every law enforcement agency you could think of was in attendance at his funeral today, including some as far away as Las Vegas and Chicago, all gathering to salute a comrade they never met, all from right here in West Texas. Live in the studio, I'm Lauren Landman, CBS 7 News.